Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Monday of the 27th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. Within your will, O Lord, all things are established, and there is none that can resist your will. For you have made all things, the heaven and the earth, and all that is held within the circle of heaven. You are the Lord of all.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, I am amazed that you are so quickly forsaking the one who called you by the grace of Christ for a different gospel. Not that there is another, but there are some who are disturbing you and wish to pervert the gospel of Christ. But even if we are an angel from heaven, should preach to you a good gospel other than the one that we preach to you, let that one be accursed. As we have said before, and now I say again, if anyone preaches to you a gospel other than the one that you received, let that one be accursed. Am I now currying favor with human beings or God? Or am I seeking to please people? If I were still trying to please people, I would not be a slave of Christ. Now I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that the gospel preached by me is not of human origin, for I did not receive it from a human being, nor was I taught it, but it came through a revelation of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart in the company and assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
The works of his hands are faithful and just. Sure are all his precepts, reliable forever and ever, wrought in truth and equity.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
He has sent deliverance to his people. He has ratified his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. His praise endures forever.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
Alleluia, alleluia. I give you a new commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
There was a scholar of the law who stood up to test Jesus and said, "Teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus said to him, "What is written in the law? How do you read it?" He said in reply, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your being, and with all your strength, and with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself." He replied to him, "You have answered correctly. Do this and you will live." But because he wished to justify himself, he said to Jesus, "Who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied, "A man fell victim to robbers as he went down from Jerusalem to Jericho. They stripped and beat him and went off, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down that road, but when he saw him, he passed by on the opposite side. Likewise, a Levite came to the place, And when he saw him, he passed by on the opposite side. But a Samaritan traveler who came upon him was moved with compassion at the sight. He approached the victim, poured oil and wine over his wounds, and bandaged them. Then he lifted him up on his own animal, took him to an inn, and cared for him. The next day, he took out 2 silver coins and gave them to the innkeeper with the instruction, "Take care of him. If you spend more than what I have given you, I shall repay you on my way back." Which of these 3, in your opinion, was neighbor to the robber's victim? He answered, "The one who treated him with mercy." Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So today we have this very familiar and very beautiful parable. Probably, as I mentioned, I think a couple of weeks back, probably 2 of the most beautiful parables, no? The parable of the Good Samaritan and the parable of the prodigal son. No? And I think, let me invite you to reflect on 3 points. No? How the parable defines, or how the Lord rather, through the parable, defines the meaning of neighbor. And then, I'd like you to take a look at the reactions, you know, of the 3 people, no? The priest, the Levite, and the Samaritan. And then finally, to reflect on the necessity of action, no? These 3 points, no? for today. Siguro magandang pagnilayan natin to, dahil nga itong parable ng prodigal son ay pinapakita kung anong kahulugan ng ating kapwa. Sino ba ang ating kapwa-tao? Tapos pangalawang punto na ating pagninilayan ay yung tugon ng 3 tao sa parable, ano? Tapos yung panghuli ay makikita natin na mahalaga sa ating pananampalataya at mahalaga sa ating masasabing sentral na biyaya na ano, no, na habag o pagkaawa at pagkupkup sa kapwa, mahalaga ang pagkilos, no? Hindi lamang pakiramdam, kundi pagkilos. First, about the neighbor and how it defines the neighbor. Very clearly here, the Lord tells us that our neighbors are the ones who are suffering and our neighbors are the ones who are victims of the social injustice, if you wish, no? Of the evils of our time. That in a sense, the Lord highlights, remember what we always said, no? that from the very beginning, part of the message of the Lord, or central to the message of the Lord, is a preferential option for the poor and the suffering. And here you have that very clearly highlighted in this parable, that our neighbors are the people in need, that our neighbors are the victims of the injustices and the evils of this world. Siguro yung unang punto ng pagninilay, ito ang ating kapwa. No? Ito ang mga ating mga, hindi lang kapitbahay, kundi mga kapwa-tao. Lalong-lalo na yung mga nagiging biktima, no, ng lahat ng kasamaan sa mundo, kasakiman at lahat ng kawalan ng katarungan. Malinaw yan, di ba, sa turo ng Panginoon, ano, na kailangan meron tayong pagkiling sa ganitong mga kasama natin. And then the second point is the reactions of the 3, no? Remember what I always say, no, when we reflect on this parable, that the reactions of the priest and the Levite are not because of evil intentions. It's just that they did not want to get out of their comfort zone. No? The priest did not want to become declared unclean in case the victim was dead. And then the Levite was afraid that if he stopped, it might be a trap. No? There might be other people waiting to rob him, actually. No? Might be a scam. So you realize that they are not particularly evil or selfish persons. They're maybe self-centered. They did not want to get out of their comfort zone. No? And perhaps that is something that I invite you to reflect on. What are the moments in our own life that we were afraid to get out of our comfort zone? At that moment when something is calling us, no, as the call of what is urgent, no, or what is imperative in a situation. And very often, we are all, in a sense, guilty of that, no? Not because we are bad people, but because we are scared to get out of our comfort zones. So mahalaga ito, no, ng pagnilaya natin yon, na hindi masama itong mga taong hindi tumulong, no? Pero takot lang sila. At takot silang lumabas sa kanilang, sabi nga natin, yung comfort zone, ano? Pero merong tawag ang mahalaga na hinihiling sa atin na tayo ay, sabi nga din sa Ebanghelyo, na to go the extra mile, ano? Na tayo ay talagang itaya ang ating sarili. So, tanungin natin ang ating sarili, yung mga pagkakataon na hindi tayo nagtaya, lalong-lalo na para sa mga nangangailangan. And then the third and final point is, again, a very beautiful reminder to us, no? That it is not enough that we feel compassion, it is not enough that we feel mercy or solidarity, but all of these assume meaning when we act. When we act out of compassion, when we act out of mercy, when we act out of solidarity. In the same way that the Good Samaritan was moved with compassion, as the gospel told us, and moved with compassion, he got off, no? He got out of his comfort zone, got off of his animal, and helped the one who was in need. That action is a very important part of compassion and mercy. So mahalaga na itong huling puntong ito ay atin din pagnilayan. Maraming pagkakataon din na nakakaramdam tayo ng malasakit at habag at awa sa ating kapwa. Pero mahalaga na hindi matapos sa pakiramdam, kundi magbunga ito sa pagkilos. Sa pagkilos upang tayo'y makiisa, no? Hindi lamang parang tumulong na dole out, kundi makiisa sa ating mga kapwa, lalong-lalo na sa mga nangangailangan. Let us continue our Mass and let us pray that the Lord may inspire us to be good Samaritans. Even today, many lie by the side of the road waiting for liberating words or a helping hand. Let us pray to the Father in heaven that our love may be expressed in concrete action rather than in beautiful words. Let us pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church, in her pastors and people, may show the love of God through active love of neighbors. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work for the destitute will never lose heart or be discouraged. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may treat every person we meet with kindness and respect. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now offer our prayer for our nation.
Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming proyekto na magtatag ng isang lipunang may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan. Kalayaan mula sa kahirapan na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay. Kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon. Kalayaan mula sa panlilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon. Kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na itaguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service. Graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love, we celebrate his death. With living faith, we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together let us offer our prayer for an end to the pandemic and to rebuild our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who help see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly work to render genuine service, especially to those who suffered the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which you have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us now offer our prayer for peace and joy for our world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much to do, and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name, and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past and not only survives the present, but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace and joy that the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, won for us. For all those affected by calamities natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time, amen. Our Lady, Mother of God and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for joining us. And remember to pray the Holy Rosary as a family today, this month being the month of the Holy Rosary. So marami pong salamat. Have a good day and have a good week ahead. Thank you.
Ako po si Bishop Jose Colin Bagaporo, ang National Director ng Caritas Philippines at Chairperson ng Episcopal Commission on Justice and Peace ng Social Action. At ngayong October 8 po, meron tayong Bike for Kalikasan in celebration of the season of creation. Kaya paanyaya ko po sa inyong lahat, makiisa po tayo, sumali po tayo sa gagawin nating Bike para sa Kalikasan mula Katedral ng Maynila hanggang La Mesa Dam. Pagdating po natin sa La Mesa Dam, makakaroon po tayo ng bamboo planting. Ito po ang launching natin ng ating bamboo planting project all over the Philippines. Bike for Kalikasan in celebration of the season of creation.